chapter ends.
1, 2, 3.
A new one now begins. Time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are ending. But I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. Where the water meets the land, there is shifting in the sand, like the tide that ebbs and flows. Memories will come and go. Faces left behind, it's hard to walk away from the best of days. But if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. This is where the chapter ends. A new one now begins. Time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are ending. But I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. We have the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away.
remain standing for the arrival of the Governor General. Please sit for a moment. I'll indicate to you when to stand, but please be ready to stand shortly. There is a car. Oh, here we are. Please stand. I'm sorry. Please stand. He's here. We stand to welcome His Excellency, the Governor General. At this time, I call on graduand Jada Emmanuel, who will lead us in a patriotic rendition of our national anthem. We can go no further without acknowledging the Creator and Lord of all things. And so I call on graduand Zania Sandy, who will lead us in a word of prayer.
Gracious Lord, we thank you for gathering each and every one of us here today safely. Today, As we celebrate all that we have been and all that we will become, we ask that God's blessing will wrap everyone in a cloak of love and protection. On behalf of the graduates, we give thanks for the last 5 years, for this is definitely an unforgettable and so far most challenging chapter of our lives. Please continue to be our strength and companion as we unite to move on to our next chapter. I pray that everything that has been planned for today will be successful and will lead to a very unforgettable one for everyone present today. We bless your holy name. We give you all the glory and the honor. We praise you, omnipotent God. Thank you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And let the people of God say, Amen. Please be seated. Before we go any further, there is a car blocking the place for the EMTs. So if you are parked at the entrance, at the main entrance of the school, which is reserved for the principal and the EMTs, please, I invite you to shift your vehicle. Thank you. Our most distinguished guest, His Excellency, the Governor General, Sir Errol Charles, District Representative for Castries North, Honorable Stevenson King, our esteemed guest speaker, Reverend Deacon Anthony Pierre, District Education Officer, Mrs. Lyril Arthur Stanislaus. Ministry officials from the Department of Education, Innovation, Gender Relations, and Sustainable Development. Representative from the St. Lucia Civil Service Credit Cooperative, Mr. Dubois. District Counselor, Mrs. Patricia Valsin. Present and past teaching staff of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, our distinguished principal, Ms. Marva Daniel, Vice Principal, Ms. Anne Gifford Elcock, and the entire CCSS administrative team, heads of department, special homeroom teachers of the class of 2022, all past and present non-teaching staff members of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, all of our voluntary RK teachers, corporate sponsors, distinguished sponsors, and generous donors, our specially invited guests, friends, and well-wishers of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, executive members of the CCSS, PGTA, parents, guardians, friends of the graduating class of 2022, the class of 1985, representative of our beloved Andy Delmar Foundation, members of the class of 2022, and all who are viewing us virtually through our YouTube channel, we thank you for your positive feedback. It is much appreciated. I welcome you all to our 2022 graduation exercise under the theme, Dubut Asam, Turn a Page to Another Chapter. I am Jason Ignatius Michael Bissett, and I am your master of ceremonies this morning. I welcome you to one of the premier learning institutions on the island. Indeed, we are unique in our excellence. Today, we celebrate another cohort of young men and women who for 5 years have been formed in knowledge, skills, and attitudes to be leaders not of tomorrow, but leaders of today. Graduates, with joy and pride, we give thanks for the journey you have now completed and we encourage you for the road ahead. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to call on the graduands who have been members of the school choir, led by Ms. Akela Xavier, as they lead us in song.
Testing.
Before Ms. Xavier starts, I call on the driver of PG926. PG926, your vehicle is blocking the EMTs. Could you please shift your vehicle? Thank you.
Face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can when I can while I can for my people. As the clouds roll back and the stars feel the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up. Take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you have freedom calling? Gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones. Early in the morning, before the sun begins to shine, we're gonna start moving towards our separated line. I'm wading through muddy waters. You know I got a made up mind. And I don't mind if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I'll fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you have freedom come?
Keep on keeping on. I'm gonna stand
Thank you.
Thank you.
I saw some faces transfixed by that voice and stage presence. Such is the talent of the students of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. Ms. Marva Daniel is the individual who has been tasked over the years with captaining this ship. And it is an unenviable task, but one that she carries out with dignity. And so I call on the principal of the Castries Comprehensive School, Ms. Marva Daniel, to deliver her remarks.
May I call forward my elves of last night? You know yourselves. Please take position to my left. Your Excellency, please permit me to adopt the protocol already established. Thank you. 11:15 p.m., 7th July. We are working, we are happy, we are pleased to prepare for the 46th graduation exercise. 11:16 p.m., the computer is about to blow up from the steam of engagement. And I'm not giving up because I need to speak to parents, to guests, to students this morning. 11:18, my front door is about to break down as my night security rushes in, petrified, out of breath, because he's running away. What, running away from and running away to what would be a secure space. Running away from at 11:19 p.m. on 7th July. From thugs on our compound with guns ready to steal, to destroy, and to kill. This was my experience last night. Parents, students, invited guests. We may very well have not had a graduation this morning because those who come to steal also come to kill. And not just destroy. And I said, why am I speaking when there's so much despair? Why should I even speak when there's so little gratitude and thanks and acknowledgement and support by so many? But Your Excellency, ministry officials, invited guests, parents, we are CCSS. We are CCSS. We are survivors. If we beat COVID, we can beat the thieves because we have hope, we have faith, and we have determination. And we stand steadfast knowing that the God that we serve will never let us down. We may not get everything right all the time. We may fail. We may make errors. We may disappoint, but not without trying. And this is my song. This is my fervent and urgent prayer to all and everyone. We have dysfunctional, diseased, and very sick minds. But this should not stop the causes. This should not stop the fight. To put a sum means that we have to do it together. When there is any gap created by anybody who you have engaged with to make a dent of added value in your homes, in our schools, in our churches, in our societies, let us stand together. If the school does not call you, walk forward. If the church doesn't reach you, reach out. Reach out. Don't just be complacent as recipients of what could be more if only every single person engaged and added more value. Let us not sit back and claim to be victims, but victors of a system we have little control over. Let our rhetoric, when we pray, dictate our action. Let not just say, Lord, Lord, please give, but say, Lord, Lord, thank you. And this is what our graduation is about today. Giving thanks for those who added value to this institution over the years in everything that they did. And this is why there is school leaving and there is graduation. Our students from day one, in forms 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, have been taught to receive not just skills and training, but values that would position them in the world today, which is a very small world. COVID has taught us that. By flicking on your screens, putting on your phones, you are in Timbuktu, Zanzibar, and wherever you never knew before, but vicariously, you can transport yourselves to through the worldwide world. So let's get it right, and let's fix it together. The school has not, what have you done? The teacher has not, what have you done? The student has not, what have I done? And let us not give in. To give up and to play victim is to give in to the thugs. To give up and to turn our backs is to create the monsters that they have become that would eventually impact on your lives because they'll enter your homes that you think are safe. Let us not give up. And so today, the turning of a page to another chapter is not just for the students. It's for each and every single one of us. Every single one of us. If yesterday we were lackadaisical and non-caring and recipients only, let us be the ones giving added value to every space that we live, that we work, that we move around. So persons who engage will feel the support. 11:21. I call the police. 11:22, I'm calling the police. 11:23, the security is shaking in my office last night. They are scared. I don't know why I wasn't. You kill me, you kill my body, you don't kill my soul. You speak evil, it speaks about you. Because it tells me what's in your heart. It doesn't kill me. And if we only knew that, we would stop the negative energies and step forward together to make today and every space that we engage in a better place. I could stand here as the principal and tell you, Okompri did this, our teachers did that. Everybody here should know. We are one of the most visible schools because our Moodle platform, our YouTube channels show you what happens every single day. Every single day, when we are off-site, we are even more engaged. We're so much engaged, asked Dr. Louis, that it took the Ministry of Education 3 days to export CCSS's content to another server. because we had so much sharing with students that parents sometimes don't even know. Because we're so busy providing for our children, we miss out. And of course, as I have invited my elves, I call them, because last night we were here trying to make sure that the standard we've kept for the past 46 years is maintained. And even after they were gone, when I left her minutes to 1 a.m., I knew that we are not going to give up. We are not going to give in. And if I'm the only one who will stand to make sure the next day or the next minute makes a difference in a child's life, I will do it alone. And so this morning, as our students who have spent the best years of their academic lives with us, who have been recipients of such enriched engagements, our 8 subject departments have certainly planned and dished out instruction that will position them in the world of academia, the world of work, and in their societies. Our English and business teachers synergized to ensure that all the cognates added value to each and every student to ensure and secure the transfer of knowledge from one subject to the other. BT, TD, bio, chemistry, we saw teachers going on field trips here, there, and everywhere with our children. And why is it everybody should know, Your Excellency? Nobody leaves here without permission. We get permission from the DO, we get permission from the parents. So telling you is only for those who probably have not been part of our life at CCSS. Our vocational teachers certainly need to be commended. And I call forward Miss Daisy, Deborah Daisy, and Mrs. Kodra, who have added such value this term and last term to our school by when no other school but Vidbute decided they would participate in the mango competition and the banana competition and the mango exposition. Our teachers said, yeah, we have SBAs to do. Yes, we have final assessments, but no, we are not going to stay out of this. Miss Daisy, come forward and take a bow. Mrs. Kodra, where are you? I know you're at the back. Please come forward and take a bow. Come on, children. Come on, parents. These teachers worked fervently, feverishly, and never gave up to show the world how ingenious, how creative we can be. And Your Excellency, I hope you get the mango cheesecake and the banana quiche that the students made and the banana wraps and pemmi that our students created in this lab at CCSS. And even if it's not much, it's noteworthy. Thank you, Miss Daisy. Mrs. Alexander and Miss Satney with other teachers, Miss Tand, I know we have given you a little token, but still, we need to commend these individuals for the staging of Banjo Man. Miss, remain standing. Parents, you heard it. You heard it when they came in August of 2017. No other school puts on productions like CCSS. No other school has put on plays more than us. I don't know what they've done. And it's not Talfest or Hess Explosion or whatever. We're talking about Hollywood level of production. Director Alexander, thank you. Thank you. And the list goes on. We have Mr. Celestin, who on his own ensures that our students are not just taught within the confines of classrooms, ladies and gentlemen. He takes them to the highest and most elitist society of visitors. Sandals Grand gets the reception that blows their minds off when our choir performs through the expert guidance of Mr. Celeste. Where is he? So, stand up. A bottle of wine. Thank you, Mr. Celestin. Thank you. Don't get too intoxicated. We need you to direct. Thank you. And it's not just about the teachers. We have persons in our midst, and this is my presentation, not to just say what we've done and take the praise at school. School belongs to every one of us sitting here. Ministry officials, give us the authority. Parents, if it were not for you, where would we be? All right? And so, it gives me great pleasure to say from Form 1 to Form 5, this parent, so I need this, and it's at my door. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the parent who has been the most committed by not just being a parent here. He served on the PTA, and he gave us two of the most brilliant minds, Mr. Edison Raoul. Come on. Take a bow, sir. Take a bow. Take a bow. Thank you.
Bottle of wine.
Come on, sir. Come on, take a bow. Thank you. And Mr. Raoul and his wife get a spa treatment from Calabash Cove. Massage for him and his wife. If she didn't say yes, I guess he wouldn't be able to say yes too. So thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Raoul is here every single day. Every single day. And he not just gives of his treasure, he gives of his time and his talent. And I need to say thank you, sir, from Form 1. Not this graduating class only, but also last year. Both of his children attended CCSS and didn't just come in placidly. They made their records known. And we will hear this. Sarah Raoul, please stand. Stand up, Sarah, who from Form 1 has been so outstanding in your engagement. And guess what? Very calm and composed. Not seen under anybody's radar. Going her merry way, doing her good things, and excelling. And Sarah, in February, was crowned the most outstanding student on the island, in the region, in mechanical engineering for St. Lucia, for CCSS. Continue to do well. Continue to perform well. God be with you, my dear. You'll get what's due to you later. And CCSS's philosophy has always been to develop holistically the children you send to us, parents. We don't just sit by and, you know, figure out how the brains work in the classroom. We put them on the field. And I asked him to call us. Right now, we have not just our best table tennis player, not just the regional best table tennis player, but possibly the most outstanding international table tennis player, DeAndre Cauldron. Where is his mom? I asked her, make sure she doesn't. Thank you, miss. In Germany, competing and hopefully to continue studies in his field of whatever chosen career he has decided. Miss, please keep standing. Thank you for giving us your son. Thank you for being committed to his engagements at CCSS. Thank you. We have Form 4s who have done well and performed exceedingly well in St. Lucia, have represented us in under 17 cricket, female football, and volleyball matches regionally, and they continue to shine. And this is what we talk about, standing together for a good cause, supporting them, finding out how else can I help you children? What else school can I do to provide for these children who continue to add value to our institution? That's why I tell the boys, you don't want to change how nicely you look. You look like handsome young men. Why do you want to look like girls? Why do you want to mark your foreheads, your eyebrows, your skin when God has made you perfect? Why should a razor define you when God has made you perfect? That's our prayer. Graduates, what's our prayer? Let me hear you. What's our school's prayer? Thank you. If you have come from God and you are ordained by God, why should man change you? Why do you look outward to earthly pleasures, likes? You have the most Instagram pages, the most likes on Facebook, the most likes on all of your different social media platforms, and create footprints that don't add value to your next chapter. Why? When you pray that you are made from God, you come from Him, you don't need man to tell you what and who you are. Come on, children, turn a page to another life. And so I end saying thank you to the teachers who engage in our various sporting clubs, Miss Hatton Stand, Miss Joseph Stand, Interact, Dukas, Red Cross over the years, Miss Emmanuel. We have our peer helpers, the counselor, our cadet, Mr. Mondesi. And if I forget any, please forgive me. I have yet received more than 2 hours sleep. Commendations, of course, to you teachers, going beyond the call of duty. Thank you, Vice Principal. Thank you for your hours of trying to teach our boys, especially, that they belong. Guys, you can make a difference. Stop telling people you're marginalized. Common Entrance showed it this year in the results. The top 6 students were male students. All right? You have the power. And if you unite in your resources as males, people will see exactly what you are. And if you turn to your handbook, as I continue to pray that as the new school year commences, we will learn from our mistakes. Fabuni Dublin's mom, please forgive me for our errors of the past few days. I eagerly ask you to join with us to pursue strategies to capture each moment that will add more value to our engagement here as parents, staff, students, and friends of CCSS. Class of 1985 leads the way in that. Every year for the past 3 years, they have at least 5 students made sure they've been recipients of the Urban Prairieville Award, giving them full payment for their CXCs. Come, let's give them a round of applause. And this year, the Andy Delma Foundation not only funded the prize for the Spirit of CCSS, but also donated $1,500 towards this year's graduation. Come on, let's give them a round of applause. Janu, continue to be our friend. Continue to support us. Thank you, Janu. Thank you, Creek Funeral Home, not parlor, no ice cream there. Only good things happen. We bury the dead well there. Free advertisement. And of course, we have so many more of our friends, our corporate sponsors, who continue to support us. And more importantly, they ensure that each day brings about a positive change in all of our engagements. And so today is not just about reflecting. It's not just about saying thanks to parents and so on. I've said so to some of the students. But I'd like our teachers to join me. You have the certificates, come forward. And parents, you know, we are not omnipresent, nor are we powerful enough to know what happens all around. But I'd like all our prefects to please stand. And your homeroom teachers and some of our ushers will come to you with a little token of appreciation for having served as class prefects for the year 2021-2022. Give them a round of applause. Ms. Suma, please remain standing. You represented administration as prefects. You represented administration as teachers. You represented students as student managers. And so now you're receiving your certificates, and I ask the teachers who are the homeroom teachers of these students who stand, please help. Come on, let's do this quickly. Our graduation is supposed to be flawlessly, seamlessly fluid. Come on, let's do this. Come on, homeroom teachers, please come and assist. Okay. Miss Not. Ms. Sumo. Okay, students, just go stand next to the students. So as the names are called, they have received it. We're not giving it to them as the names are called. Just give the students their certificates. Ms. Suma will call all the names out quickly. Come up, Ms. Suma, as our chief in charge of prefect system at CCSS. Let's give Ms. Suma a resounding round of support.
The prefects, five business. Haley Berthier, Abigail Bissett, Malaika Flotten, Aaron Gerald, Oriana Henry, Antonia Jamari, Michelle Joseph, Hannah Jules, Avanel Leos. That's five business. Five general, Destiny Isambut, Venetia Moffat, Sarah Raoul, Mackenzie Regis, Zania Sandy, Kanasha St. Luce. Five technical, Giovanni Alexander, Darren Ogist, DeAndre Cauldron, Janae Kalu, Kyle Deterville, Jadon Gray, Janoa Sonson, Azante Stephen, Gerald Yard, Alexi Kodra, and Yannick Octave. Five Science, Michaela Antoine, Celeste Alt, Jada Charles, Omika Common, Daniela Dorset, Jada Emmanuel, Ashel Faisal, Marissa Fannis, Nalia Favrier, Trudy Francis, Joy George, Melanie Gittens, Alyssa Herbert, Jaden Jawahir, Conria Joseph, Jaden Joseph, Anaj Leon, Brianna McVeigh, Tanisha Spooner, and Rayona Stone. Five vocational, Caitlin Sinner, Raven Gabriel, Sinaya Gatno, Rianne Longville, Sapphire Octave, Daniela Richelieu, Vishal Singh, and Kishana Smith. These 54 prefects served under the leadership of our male head prefect, Yannick Octave, and our female head prefect, Zania Sandy. Please put your hands together for the Form 5 prefect body. Five technical certificates, who has it? Thank you for your service, prefects, and for adding immense value to our esteemed institution. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Ms. Suma. Thank you very much, Ms. Suma. Please don't go. You're the head prefect for the prefects. So please come collect a little token of our appreciation. Thank you, Ms. Suma, again. And why are we here today? You notice, the ball has started. We're here today to commend students for their 5 years of positive engagement, added value, And today we stand together to give tribute to those students who have been steadfast, resilient, and made it to the end. To the end. To the end. Even if you drive from here to Viewfort and you take the red lights at Clark Street and you hit a passenger crossing the pedestrian, you're not a perfect driver. That one incident causes you probably a lifetime in jail. So we continue to drive well. And so I ask the vocational students to please stand. What makes you present here today is that you've been eligible to be graduates of CCSS. And so I call on Mrs. Alexander, Razan Alexander, Ms. Sharon Bernard, and Mr. Closel to present you with what qualifies you to be a student here today. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates and soon-to-be graduates of Class of 2022, 5 Vocational.
Five Vocational, Kathleen Sinnott, Graven Gabriel, Sanaya Gatno, Rianne Longville, Angel Moses, Sophia Octave, Daniela Richelo, Layla Setut, Kishana Smith, Lenora Senval, Akela Xavier, Claude Alt, Jada Louis, Micah Meda, Vishal Singh, Kumani Thompson. Thank you, Five Vocational.
Mr. Closel, Ms. Bernard, and Ms. Alexander, please come forward to receive a little token of appreciation as the homeroom teachers who have served these students for the past 3 years. And I call on Vishal Singh, Akela Xavier, please come forward, and Kishana Smith, please come to present to your homeroom teachers just a little token of appreciation. Okay, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates of 5 Vocational. We now ask 5 Technical to please stand, and we'll ask Ms. Suma to assist Mr. St. Luce, as you have been doing over the years, and Ms. Bina Joseph to assist in the distribution of certificates as Mr. St. Luce gets the deserved pleasure of calling out his children's names whilst they receive their certificates. Ms. Suma and Ms. Joseph. We'd also like to identify with Ms. Weeks, who has been out, Mrs. Daisy Fred, who is on maternity leave, who's their other homeroom teacher. So unfortunately, this is why Mr. St. Luce is the Lone Ranger visibly seen here today. But definitely not alone. We're standing together with him. Amen? Amen? Amen. Thank you. So, Ms. Suma, Technica, let's go as he calls the names. We do this.
You want for Bunny Zone, right?
No, it's not.
I told Jameson to do it.
It's going to be Bunny Zone.
You shouldn't stop it for you?
Good morning, everybody. In 5 technical, we have Kyle Amab, Giovanni Alexander, Darren Ogist, DeAndre Cauldron, Keithan Shalmine, Brendan Connibert, Kyle Littleville, Jalen Daisy, Jabari Emilier, Ajani Ferdinand, Vernon Francis, Jaden Gray, Nicholas Wong, Ethan John, Alexi Kodra, Omari Lafilier, Ajani Meda, Carlos Modest, Yannick Octave, Dylan Philogene, Jonathan Philogene, Lethal Popo, Janoa Sonson, Daniel Smith, Azante Stevens, Gerald Yard, and Fabuni Dublin. Those will be the males. We also have Janae Kalu, Jaleesa Campbell, and Kimani Pamphil. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you, 5 Technical.
Yannick Octave, please come forward to present your homeroom teacher his little token of appreciation. And hopefully, Mr. St. Luce, you will not get too intoxicated completing the Met SBAs that we got extension for. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, why did you sit? You are now graduates of 5 Technical, class of 2022. Please stand and take your bows. Very much, and we move on. We now ask that 5 business stands. Sorry, 5 science. Please stand, 5 science, and invite on stage Mr. Chandler will deliver to you, and Miss Frederick, your home teacher, will call out your names. Mr. Chandler, please come forward quickly. Miss Suma and Miss, since it's a very large homeroom, Miss Suma, please assist Mr. Chandler. And Miss Bina Joseph, thank you.
From 5 Science, Daniela Amede, Michaela Antoine, Celeste Alt, Miracle Brown, Jada Charles, Omika Common, Danella Dorset, Eugenie Silis, Ashelle Faisal, Marissa Fannis, Nalia Favry, Trudy Francis, Joy George, Melanie Gittens, Alyssa Herbert, Conria Joseph, Anaj Leo, Brianna McVeigh,
Kumia Popo, Tanisha Spooner, Rayona Stone. Those were the girls, and now our males. Davani Emma, Tristan James, Jaden Jawahir, Jaden Joseph, Giovanni Mangal, and Nicholas Braville. Put your hands together for Form 5 Science.
Omika Kaman, please come forward to present to your woman teacher. And Marissa Franis, please come forward to present to your woman teachers a little token of our appreciation. Miss Ansa, please come up. Miss Ronald Biska will give to the student to give to you. General is mothered, babied, tutored by three, not one, not two, homeroom teachers. So we call on Miss Tessa Amab, Mr. Austin Phillip, and Ms. Nicole Edgard to present to five general who will stand now to receive their certificates of a graduation.
We start with the females of Five General. Kadia Charles, Phoebe Dover, Carla Gist, Destiny Isembert, Ednika James, Mulan Job, Venetia Moffat, Sarah Raoul, Mackenzie Regis, Zania Sandy, Kanasha St. Luce, Tyrisa Timet, Kimani Pamphil, 5 general males, Jaden Alexander, Seri Danzi, Jaquan Degazor, Tayshon Dubison, Sergey Ephraim, Taj Mangal, Isaiah Nicholas, Dave Regis. Ladies and gentlemen, 5 general.
Sean, please come forward. Phoebe and Destiny, please come forward. Mr. Austin, Miss Emma, please come forward. Thank you so much, class of 2022, 5 general. You're now graduates. Let's put your hands together. And last, by no means least, our business education from 5 students. Please stand. We invite Mrs. Natrum and Mr. Blanchard. I'm sure they've decided, because they mean business, who will be up here and who will be down there. Your Excellency, the 116 students who were made eligible today submitted all their SBAs, attended school every single day, punctually even, very, and of course, submitted their assignments. We had no difficulties in ensuring that when they had disciplinary issues, we dealt with them together with their parents. And in some cases, when we didn't, we, of course, picked up the slack and took our licks when we didn't. But we made sure that all of the students here got what they deserved to graduate.
Five business females, Chamilla Benjamin, Haley Berthier, Abigail Bissett, Ajani Diamond, Malaika Flotten, Sierra George, Zivi Hall, Oriana Henry, Chelsea Hippolyte, Antonia Jamari, Michelle Joseph, Melody Joseph, Hannah Jules, Avnel Leos, Dyla Mathre, Faye St. Edward, and Mia Tuse. And the only boy or male from 5 business, Aaron Gerald. Ladies and gentlemen, 5 business.
Mayor and Gerald, please come forward. And we have Mr. Clark assisting us with Aaron to give our teachers a little token of appreciation. As the Lone Ranger, taking care of all of these goods, Aaron Gerald. Thank you so much, Mrs. Natrum and Mr. Blanchard, for your 3 years of devotion, commitment, and steadfast quality homerooming, if there's such a word. Thank you. And so, class of 2022, you have joined the alumni. Please stand to sing your song of thanks. Lord, we thank you. The first class to get it right on the first rehearsal, so don't let me down. After three, and you can follow parents, guardians, and our guests in the handbook. Lord, we thank you. It's actually on page four. This song was written by our former head of Department of Modern Languages, former staff member, Mr. Cuthbert Anselm, and it's in tribute to him today as he continues to journey through his challenges. 2, 3. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. We thank you, Lord, for our whole sacrifice through the years. As we grew through the years, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. We thank you, Lord, for all through the years. We thank you, Lord, for them as we learn through the years. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. And finally, we thank you, Lord, for our true friends. The years, we thank you, Lord, for them. As we struggle through the years, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you, oh Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for every gift you've given us. We thank you each day. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for our RK teachers who continue to make sure they remembered to thank the Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, I've come to my first half of my presentations. Congratulations, as the end of this chapter draws to an end. Please savor in the bliss of hope, and please do capture, even if for just a little while, today, the splendor of all your achievements. God bless you, everyone. Thank you.
We are CCSS. We have hope. We endure. We contribute. We excel in spite of. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we have the distribution of subject awards. And for this, I call on our vice principal, Ms. Anne Gifford Elcock, and the district education officer, Ms. Ray's Lyril Arthur Stanislaus, will be assisting. As they come forward, let me just give you an idea of the criterion for these subject awards. It considers students' overall performance in the subject area for the past 3 academic years, that's forms 3 to 5. Students' behavior must also be given due consideration.
The description of each of them. You did this one already? Thank you.
The first subject award goes to is auto mechanics, and it's awarded to Azanti Steven.
Some cry, some smile, some fight every day. We ride to the top, 'cause we know what it takes. Through it all, we survive, yet still hold the faith. Unchangeable, Lord, unchangeable. Hey, no matter how the dollar might stack up, me still not change, me I go steer off. Inna the giddy and your affy, buckle up your lace, be smart, don't be a prof now. Life, it's a journey, it's a long race. Mama says,
our second subject award is technical drawing, and the awardee for this award is Tayshawn Dubiso. The Building Technology Award. The proud recipient of that award is none other than Yannick Octave.
Stuck up, me still not change, me I go steer off. Inna the giddy and your affy, buckle up your lace, be smart, don't be a prof, no, no. Life, it's a journey, it's a long race. Mama says, son, be wise and don't bring
electronics and electrical technology. The proud recipient is Sarah Raoul.
The truth and that can't erase. So hell to all of those who are
And Sarah Raul also receives the award for mechanical engineering. And just a little bit of more information to complement the award, she is the goddaughter of the district education officer. Round of applause. The Agricultural Science Award goes to Omika Common. We would like to award the Physical Education and Sport Award to Zania Sandy.
Student, and this is a student whose performance in two technical subjects, at least two, has been outstanding during the entire 3 years at Upper School Castries Comprehensive. And I'll allow Miss Frederick to announce this.
So it's our privilege this morning to award the best technical award to Yannick Octave.
Stuck up, me still not change. Me, I go steer off. In a diggity and your affy, buckle up your lace, be smart.
We continue the subject awards. We would like to award Elisa Herbert for the best restaurant server. Elisa. We have two recipients for the Food and Nutrition and Health Award. And I would like to call on Melanie Gittens and Venetia Moffat.
So me tell you to learn, then mama be strong.
faith in God, me no know about man. Long time them a try bring me down, and not just now, from a very young. Chat me every day with them funny tongue. Them a watch me on the telly now.
Clothing, textiles, and fashion goes to Tyler Mafre. Visual arts comes in two components. We have visual art expression and art, and we have visual art craft. So the first visual art expression award goes to Raven Gabriel. And the second one goes to Michael Madoff. Theater arts also comes with two components, dance and drama. So we would like to award the Drama Prize to none other but Kishana Smith. And the Dance Award goes to Ashel Faisal.
Mama says, son, be wise and don't bring disgrace. So me take up the broom and start sweep the place. Cause all these ways, they got to get erased. I love to me people that me embrace. The truth are the truth.
And our music award goes to our musician here, none other than Phoebe Dovey.
Vocational student goes to a student who has performed in both food and nutrition and clothing, textiles and fashion over the last 3 years of Castries Comprehensive School. And Ms. Frederick will announce our best vocational student.
None other than Kishana Smith. We move on now to the business awards, and the first business award is the Principles of Business Award, and would like to call on Chelsea Hippolyte. You are the proud recipient of the Principles of Business Award.
We are die.
The Egbert Combi POA Award for Principals of Accounts. This award goes to Avanel Leos. Office Administration Award goes to none other than Ciara George.
Some cry, some smile, some fight every day. We rise to the top because we know what it takes. Through it all, we survive.
The Electronic Document Preparation Management Award, what we refer to as EDPM, goes to Chelsea
Hippolyte. Life, it's a journey, it's a long race. Mama says, son, be wise and don't bring disgrace. So me take up the broom and start sweep the place. Cause all these ways, they got to get erased. I love to me people that me embrace. The truth are the truth and that can't erase. So hell to all of those who...
The Information Technology Award goes to Jaden Jarahir. And the last subject in the business department, this award goes to Chelsea Hippolyte for economics.
The best business education student has performed in the business subjects. Has been outstanding over the past 3 years.
And we would like Chelsea to remain on stage as she receives the Best Business Award. The most outstanding student in English language goes to Sarah Raoul. The most outstanding English literature award goes to none other than Raven Gabriel. We would like to call Sarah back to the stage. The most outstanding mathematics award goes to Sarah. Sarah Raoul.
The is where the chapter ends.
Sarah Raul Pabokudo Fosse is also the proud recipient of the French Award. And I just wish I could have said it in Spanish, except my apologies. She's also the proud recipient for the Spanish Award. I would like to thank Mrs. Elcock and the DO, Mrs. Stanislaus. Yes? Just for a little bit, because we would like to break for the Science Awards to be presented by Class of 85. So we'll call you back. Now we present the Science Awards. The Biology Award goes to Melanie Gatons. Best chemistry students, in fact the most outstanding in chemistry, we would like to call Sarah back to the stage. Sarah Waru. The Physics Award goes to Joy George.
If it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend.
The most outstanding student in integrated science goes to Venetia Moffat.
Our best science student is the student who has performed, obviously, the best in the science subjects.
The hardest part is when you know all.
And I allow Miss Frederick to announce this.
So the Best Science Award is sponsored by the Urban Preville Memorial Award. That's the award. And it's our pleasure to call on Rihanna Stone. You are the proud recipient of this award.
It's hard to walk away from the best of days.
Thank you very much, class of 85. And we would like to call back Mrs. Stanislaus and our dear VP, Ms. Elko. So we continue with our subject awards from the Social Sciences Department. Oh, sorry. And this department comprises of three components: history, social studies, and geography. We would like to award the history prize to Phoebe Dovey. The Social Studies Prize goes to Destiny Isenbert. And the last subject in this department, geography, we call on Jaden Joseph. You are the proud recipient. And as we close off the subject awards at this juncture, we would like to award the best academic student. And the best academic student is the student whose performance in at least 5 academic subjects has been outstanding during the last 3 years. And that student also has the highest overall GPA. And on behalf of CCSS, I would like to call on Sarah Rahul. At this point, we would like to give a token to Mrs. Stanislaus and Ms. Elcock, a small token of our appreciation. Thank you very much.
To all of you students who have received awards this morning, this must not be the last award that you receive. Go forward to receive many more. And to you who have not received this morning, small matters, you have enough time to receive many, many awards. So go forward with commitment and dedication. The gentleman whom I have the privilege of introducing this morning to address you is a gentleman I know to be a dedicated husband and father of a former CCSS student. I know him to be a gentleman of integrity and a man of God serving as a deacon within the Catholic Church. So it's my pleasure this morning to introduce, to welcome to the podium, our keynote speaker, Reverend Deacon Anthony Pierre. Excuse me, before Mr. Pierre starts, would the driver of PG 6611 please shift your vehicle? You are blocking a main entryway. Please, thank you.
Wow. Are you happy? Students, are you happy? Graduates, are you happy? Parents, are you happy? But I don't see you beaming with happiness, with smiles. Amen? This morning, graduates, parents, it gives me great pleasure to stand here. Great, great pleasure. You know, I have 5 children. 2 of them attended this beautiful, this wonderful institution. And I myself did. Class of 1987. It gives me great pleasure. So thank you, Ms. Danielle, for inviting me to speak to you. Just a few words. I won't be very long. You have made it. Students, you have made it. Graduates, you have made it. Out of the best educational, secondary educational institution there is in St. Lucia. And I represent Compre very proudly, I can tell you. Castries Comprehensive has given me an education that no other secondary school in St. Lucia could have given me. And I can tell you, you've had the best education. There are things that, you know, that I've been able to do, you know, with my Castries Comprehensive Education, that is quite, you know, unimaginable. So sometimes I say of myself, I am jack of all trades and master of some. And that is who I am. So, married for 25 years, you know, 5 wonderful children. I've been a deacon for 5 years at the Barbono Catholic Church. I want to tell you, students, you have made it. And you know what I want you to do? I want you to turn to your parents and say thank you. Turn to your parents and say thank you. Thank you. Yes. Yes, thank you. Because they've put in a lot of sweat and blood and hard work. You think you're the ones who've been doing the hard work, huh? You think you're the one who've been doing all the hard work, studying, burning the candle, you know, through 2-3 o'clock in the morning? Oh, no. Your parents have been doing so much hard work, and I want to congratulate you, parents, for, you know, just being through with your children, with your ward, and for seeing them through. As you leave the protective walls of this wonderful, this beautiful institution, graduates, you will find that life is not so rosy out there, huh? It's not so rosy. So you've had the best of the best within here, I can tell you. Out there, it's not a rosy world. It's not a beautiful world. Unless you make the choices beginning right now, life will not be a rosy world for you. The grass is not always greener on the other side. What you need to do is to continue your education and your educational pursuits. You know, Nelson Mandela once wrote, "Education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world." And not just change, you know, the world, you know, at large, but to change your world, to change your situation, to change where you're at right now. Education is the best weapon we can use to change the world. So as you continue your educational goals, life is going to get more challenging. But I say to you, graduates, be strong, be courageous, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged. Remember to dream big and have big plans. There's nothing in dreaming. There's nothing in having big plans. Early in life, I want you to learn the difference between three words. All of them begin with L, and sometimes very confusing. Lust, like, and love. I want you to learn the difference between those three. Because those will come upon you at various times in life. And having known the difference and how to deal with them would help you, you know, manage life very easily. So lust is a feeling. It's just this feeling that you get when you see someone and you have this feeling, you know, and your body tickles and trembles. You know that kind of feeling, huh, young people? You don't? You don't know that feeling? Well, I can tell you, that feeling is not love, you know. That's lust. Yes, it is. Whereas love and like is a choice. So you choose to love and you choose to like. But I want to remind you, as you do, like things and love people. Amen? So like things and love people. Never love things and like people. No, some of us, you know, we prefer to love things and all we have is gentle likeness for others. But I remind you, I tell you, love people always. Love people tenderly. Love people dearly. Love people unconditionally. And even when they don't reciprocate your love, even if when they don't give back love, I implore you, give love. In your love, remember, forgive always, never holding any grudges, and never lust after anyone or anything. Be humble and keep your feet on the ground. Be proud of who you are, no matter where you find yourself in life. You know, you may have big dreams and aspire to be doctors and nurses and, you know, all of these great and these wonderful prime ministers, whatever your dreams are. But sometimes you will not be able to achieve those dreams immediately and maybe never. But be proud of who you are. Be proud of where you are in life. Be proud of being a graduate of Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. And even if, you know, your life journey doesn't take you very far in terms of your education, still be proud. You know, I find so many persons, you know, they are so antagonized about where they find themselves in life. So I graduated out of, so let's say, you get graduates. They graduate out of Sir Arthur Lewis Community College. But you find them at the pump serving fuel. And they're grudgeful. They give you so much attitude. You know, they may be at a supermarket, at the cashier, and you can see the attitude they give you is because they're not happy with where they are in life. But I tell you, be happy, be thankful for whatever God gives you, whatever God sends you. Because right there and then in your situation, wherever you are, wherever you find yourself, God is working with you and working at you. Amen? So be thankful. Wherever you are, wherever you find yourself, even if you find yourself being a sanitation engineer, nice word for a garbage collector, be proud of it. Be proud. Because though all of us have a contribution to make to this society, all of us, we all can't be doctors. There can only be one governor general, one prime minister. So be proud. Be proud of yourself as being a St. Lucian. Carry yourself with pride and with dignity, knowing that you are made in the image and in the likeness of God. And no one can take that from you. No one can take that image and that likeness that you have been made of. And hey, whether you're able to acknowledge it, whether you recognize it, whether you want it or not, you are made in the image and in the likeness of the Almighty God. So be proud of that. And let that carry you through. Remember, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. And give thanks in all circumstances. You know that prayer that you, that song that you sung about giving thanks? And I recorded beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Within that song, saying thank you, Lord, is recorded more than 30 times. You know, many times when we pray, we just come to God with the attitude of asking, Lord, may I have, Lord, give me, Lord, give me. And you know, we never really take time to thank God for the simple things. For waking up on the morning, Lord, thank you, Lord. You know, for the breath of life, Lord, thank you, Lord, for taking you from point A to point B. So be thankful. Be thankful always. And do not forget the Lord in your youthfulness. So don't say, you know, I will serve God. I will take on a prayer life. And it is important. I will, you know, think about, you know, doing this and that when it comes to my spirituality later on. The same effort that you put towards your education, the same effort that you put towards, you know, your academic achievements, put that same effort towards your spirituality, your spiritual life. Because I can tell you, graduates, once you begin, if you do not have, and once you continue that relationship that you have with God, God never ever fails. He never fails. He will never ever fail you. He'll never ever leave you alone. He'll never leave you orphaned. That God that you and I serve is a faithful God. And doesn't matter even if your parents fail you, you know, your teachers fail you, your education fail you, everything that you have fail you, God is gonna be there to see you through. So do not forget the Lord in your youthfulness. And I want to tell you, finally, even if you fail, pick up yourself and get going again. Amen? Pick up yourself and get going again. You know, life is full of stories of persons who had failed many times and were able to pick up themselves and get going. If you look at that light bulb up there, you know who invented the light bulb? Thomas Edison. That man, 1,000 times he failed. Not 100, not 200, not 500, 1,000 times he failed in producing a working light bulb. And when he was interviewed by a reporter to ask, how do you feel about having failed 1,000 times in creating a light bulb? You know what his response was? His response was, that's not what happened, you know. It just took 1,000 tries to create a light bulb. So, I tell you, failure is gonna come. It's gonna come. But don't let failure define you. Don't let failure define you. Because you know what? Failure is success turned inside out. And every time you fail, every time you fall, you look at the where you've been, pick up the good out of it, leave the bad, and move on. Finally, lost time can never be regained or recycled. Did you hear that? Lost time can never be regained or recycled. So graduates, use your time wisely. Do not live in the past. Do not worry about the future. Enjoy the now. Because the now is all you have. Worrying about the past is not going to change the now or the future. Worrying about the future is not going to change anything. All you have, all God has given you is the now. And live in the now. Enjoy the now. Because tomorrow may never be yours. Yesterday is all gone. Amen.
Don't leave yet, Miss Deacon Pierre. There is a certificate of appreciation for you. Miss Biscom, could you assist as we show gratitude to Reverend Deacon Pierre? There's also a token here for you. Thank you so much, Reverend Deacon Anthony Pierre. At this time, we shall have the much anticipated presentation of sports awards. And for this, I call on our sports coordinators.
At this time, we would like to award our favorite, well, not favorite, but most outstanding sports personalities. And we start with the sports award in athletics. And we would like to award the male athlete. And this is none other than Carlos Modest. And our female athlete, most outstanding, is Michelle Joseph. Our most outstanding volleyball student is Anaj Leo. Our most outstanding footballers. We have two of them. And the first award goes to Jalen Daisy, male. And our most outstanding female footballer is Sophia Octave. our most outstanding netballer, Sinaya Gatno. Our most outstanding table tennis player goes to DeAndre Cauldron. And if his mom is there, yes, we would like her to collect on his behalf. We have two outstanding basketballers, male and female. And the first one goes to Jeannie Ferdinand. And Jeannie, is there anyone to collect on his behalf? Okay, and Jada Emmanuel. And we have two outstanding cricketers as well, male and female. So the first award goes to Jada Louis. Sorry, actually we have two males, not male and female this time. And Vishal Singh. Jada Louis and Vishal Singh. And I would like to make a little apology, maybe it's a big one too, that our Sports Personality Awards are yet to get here. Yes, so forgive me. But as I announce our male and female sports personality for the year, these two awards respectively go to DeAndre Cauldron, male. DeAndre. And our outstanding sports female personality is Zanya Sandy. Once again, I would like to apologize, but as soon as these awards get here, I'll make it my duty to deliver. Thank you very much, Mr. Closel.
The role of valedictorian is one which comes with much esteem, a role that is much sought after among graduates. And our valedictorian this year is a young lady who is known for her confidence and her poise. It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the podium our valedictorian for this graduation ceremony, Miss Kishana Smith.
Principal, Ms. Mava Daniel. Vice Principal, Ms. Anne Giffard Elcock. Teaching staff, ancillary staff, specially invited guests, and most importantly, the tenacious graduates of the class of 2022, it is with alacrity that I bid you all a pleasant good morning. My name is Kishana Smith, and I feel nothing less than privileged to serve as your valedictorian for the graduating class of 2022. His Excellency, good morning. This speech today aims firstly to inspire you to unleash the greatness within you. Secondly, cheer you up in what is expected to be a bittersweet moment. And finally, have you shed a tear or two? Because frankly, I don't want to be the only one up here crying. A mammoth task indeed, but nonetheless, with great CCSS pride, I stand before you today at the end of our five-year tenure at this prestigious institution. Over the years, we stood together, and now, here we are, at the end, closing off this chapter. In anticipation of what the upcoming chapters may hold, let us continue to stand together, supporting one another, as we did for the past 5 years. Class of 2022, dubut asum. Turn a page to another chapter. Allow me to start off with my alma mater's motto, which I've carried with me throughout the years. Success through perseverance and self-discipline. I offer you this piece of advice as a reminder that it is through one's dedication, determination, and hard work that the doors of opportunity, growth, and success will be unlatched. In the words of Roman philosopher Seneca, luck is what happens when preparation meets opportunity. So let's prepare to get lucky. I recall the morning of September 4th, 2017, when we all set foot within the walls of this reputable institution. That bright red and white really did something to our self-esteem. The introduction to such a foreign environment, accompanied by many other factors, such as rules, procedures, new faces, and of course the expectations which we had to uphold, brought about many moments of concern, doubt, and anxiety for me. And I am certain that it was no different for you, my fellow graduates. It was a whole new environment that we had to navigate. But the most comforting part of it was, we were about to embark on this journey together. What initially seemed like a lifetime ahead of us has flown by. And although COVID-19 has robbed us of so much time, the countless memories we've made here will forever be etched in the minds of many and engraved on the walls of CCSS. Given the fact that we all came from varying backgrounds and our experiences may have differed greatly, it might be difficult to sum up everyone's experience into a mere 10-minute speech. However, I shall try my utmost, and as such, allow me to do so acrostically. Class of 2022. C, cheerleading. One of the most anticipated sporting events on our sports calendar, especially for our young ladies. Many would gather on the field or oftentimes the auditorium where the flexibility, creativity, and elements of dance would be showcased. There came Amazonas' famous robot, which only started working 2 days prior to the competition. Then, there was little Melody, who was able to gain some height only in the cheerleading season, since she was the apex of Oriole's ugly yellow pyramid, which always needed a little more attention. If you agree, let me hear you say yeah, yeah. Right. I'm hoping that Mrs. Lord is nearby. Poor Miss Annaville, looking all hopeless in a little corner, hoping that Kira and Abigail will not forget what comes after the split. Or perhaps Daniela remembering those complicated hand movements. And so they say, save the best for last. We Finchites always knew how to shell down the place, regardless of what their opinions were.
When we touch down, the whole place shell down. When we touch down, the whole place shell down. When we touch down, the whole place shell down. When we touch down, the whole place shell down.
That's right. Those were the days when we couldn't have said a thing to Mrs. Lord or Miss Suma, for they saw nothing but victory and success in their Oriolites and Amazonians. And that no other house could have attained that trophy, even if over the years, the results may have indicated otherwise. L, look to this day. Our school's motto. I bet half of y'all didn't even know that. I recall well what a typical Monday morning would have been like when we had to begin the day with such interesting yet exhausting assemblies. Or perhaps a typical Thursday morning where we would be greeted by the informative, lengthy, yet lively discussions initiated by our homeroom teachers. The constant reminders to stay focused and resolute, especially in Forms 3 and 4, considering all the time lost, was indeed one of the most frequent subjects of their conversations. They never stopped preaching to us about the future, often lamenting on the fact that CXE and graduation were around the corner, our immediate future. In the words of Miss Lamentine, Benjamin Bob, Kalita James, you don't have time to waste. Make smart decisions in life. And indeed, we do not have the time to waste. Look at where we are now, at the end of that immediate future. For most of us, if not all, our next stop, college. Now that's an interesting future we all are looking forward to. A, anxiety. The countdown to CXE truly started from Form 1, but anxiety only kicked in January 2022 when we realized that this was really happening. CXE was around the corner. Having to stay back late hours after school, attending online sessions at night, both weekdays and weekends. This was our new normal. Sleep? What was that? A break? Never heard of it. Fortunately for us, exams got pushed back by 3 weeks. As sleep deprived us students, that was the best news we could have ever received. We are a lucky bunch indeed. S, stolen. You would think having our items stolen over the years would be enough robbery. But lo and behold, COVID-19 came along and robbed us of so many things. Our physical contact time with our teachers and friends, and the numerous memories we had to make. However, our final few months this year proved that COVID-19 could not stop us from moving forward together. S, salutation of the dawn. For yesterday is but a dream, and tomorrow is only a vision. But today, well lived makes every yesterday a dream of happiness and every tomorrow a vision of hope. So live in the moment, seize every moment, and enjoy the bliss of your growth, the glory of your action, and the splendor of your achievements. Remember, however, that failures will come because it's an integral part of success. Be not despondent, for there is always a new tomorrow, a fresh start, where in the words of Maya Angelou, the horizon leans forward, offering you space to place new steps of change. Oh, opportunity. We never miss an opportunity to go to the tap to drink water, then head to the bathroom to excrete a mixture of H2O, CH4, N2O, enzymes, and the many other components that we do not know. But let's not rack our brains. Just ask Miss Suma. All this just to stretch our legs, we try to convince ourselves. Let's not forget the opportunities we took to frequent the canteens just to pesterize Miss Maggie and Miss Betty, more so during our class times. The vexation and anxiety we caused them took up our time, which then caused us to beast class. However, let us no longer waste our opportunities in immature things. As we prepare to delve further into yet another chapter of our lives, let us be open-minded so that we see all opportunities as doors of success. If this door needs to close, do not be deterred. There are several other doors in a building. Choose the next one and enter. F. Friendship. Throughout the years, we made friends and then we lost friends. We gained new friends. We even went as far as faking friendships, which sometimes led to us fighting some friends. But in the end, we are leaving this institution loving the clans we call friends. BFFs like Joy and Anash are a complicated combo, but it's their love for them. Zania and Sophia, the comical duo, never a dull moment for these two. It's their laughter for us. Tayshon and Yori, the budding entrepreneurs, always have a new plan to make money. To all those not mentioned, your friendships are what will push you to conquer your dreams. Two Junequeyols. Having Miss Frederick chase us to bring in items to make Junequeyol what it was indicated the commencement of our annual Junequeyol celebrations. Although the main purpose behind the celebration might have been to educate us about our culture, one of the most anticipated aspects for us was the sessions. Right, my fellow graduates? Unfortunately, we only got to experience this twice. But in retrospect, I guess we could say we were being taught how to. How did Marshall say it again?
Work hard, play harder. Work hard, play harder. Work hard, play harder. Work hard.
Zero fights. Would you believe it? We did well, class of 2022, only fighting to ensure we made it to the end of our tenure here at Compre. Continue fighting for the things you want in this thing called life. Two Miss Fredericks, two Miss Alexanders, two Miss Josephs, two Kyles, two Ajani's, two Jadens, two Nicholas's, two Kira's, two Jada's, a Tukipa Afini PS. All this confusion for class of 2022. Two years of Rice Krispies, Ice Cold Juice. Who said that? Or what about peanut coconut coffee plane. Memories that will forever be cherished. For as Cesar Pavez says, we don't remember days, we remember moments. We will surely miss those condiment announcements. Of course, this was only a snippet of our lives at Castries Comprehensive, but time will not permit me to go on. As I conclude this speech, and as we close this chapter of our lives, myself and my fellow graduates would like to extend our deepest gratitude and appreciation, first and foremost, to the Almighty Father for his continued guidance, direction, and strength throughout the 5 years here at CCSS. To our parents for their never-ending love, support, and nurture. We will spend an entire lifetime thanking you, and still, it will never be enough for your unwavering support. To our hardworking and sometimes pushy teachers and school administration, we greatly appreciate your hard work, sacrifice, devotion, and contribution to both our personal and academic development. Without you, we would not be walking out of these grounds as strong and independent learners. According to Louisa May Alcott, we all have our own life to pursue, our own kind of dream to weave. Always remember that we all have some power to make wishes come true, as long as we keep believing. However, we also do need a support system, your friends, your family, and your teachers. Create a circle that will be there through both the good times and the bad, the successes and the failures, the bright days and the dark nights, and carry the baton when you need it. It is with this, my fellow graduates, that I say, no matter the degree of your ambition, seize opportunities. Take calculated risks. Make memories and achieve your desire. Class of 2022, I implore you to go forth and be a different species of butterflies. Fly high, my royal butterflies. Join me as I say, CCSS. Thank you.
Mark my words, this is a voice that you might just become very familiar with outside of the walls of Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. We are on the back end of our program this morning. At this time, we have the presentation of outstanding awards, and I call on the immediate past president of the Castries Comprehensive School, PGTA. And I also call on Dr. Claudia Louis, who will be assisting us at this time.
And this time we present the most outstanding awards, and we would like to announce the award for the most improved student. And this is a student whose overall grades have improved over the last 3 years. Behavior and deportment have improved over the last 3 years as well. And the recipients of this award, actually we have two of them, most improved male and Most Improved Female. So at this point, I would like to call on Devani Amab. And Nalia Favory. These are the two recipients of the Most Improved Award.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team in. Started from the bottom, now
the most dedicated student. This is a student whose application has been consistent in all subject areas and whose behavior is considered as well, is exemplary. We would like to award Sarah Raul, most dedicated student. The most disciplined student, male and female, and these are students whose behavior have been consistently exemplary. Such students should have a clean record in terms of their behavior, and these students' regularity and punctuality, as well as their timely completion and the submission of assignments, were given due consideration. And we would like to award Sarah Raul and Micah Maida, most disciplined students. We would also like to award the student who has been most dedicated to his or her studies and also persevered throughout his or her tenure. We also consider this student for his or her all-round dedication and excellence. And this award goes to Zanya Sandy. We also have students who, despite their challenges, they've been most consistent. But the one who has been most persevering is none other than Brianna McVean. Thank you, Mr. Raul. I'm sorry, I wasn't aware that Dr. Louis was there as well, Dr. Claudia Louis, along with Mr. Raul. Yes, so sorry about that. Thanks for your participation.
We still have two grand awards that shall be announced shortly. But at this time, we have a tribute to those people without whom these students' success, well, their existence. Their existence would not even be possible. And so to say thanks to our parents, we have a graduate, well, graduate doing so. So I call you up to give your thanks. Oh, I'm told that you just stand, graduates, to say thanks, to extend your thanks to your parents. So graduates, please stand. And we invite you to extend your thanks to your parents who are here with you this morning. Show them some love, man. Give a little hug, a little kiss. Hello. That's right. Don't be shy. Thank you, graduates. And thank you, parents. Thank you for your commitment to these young ones. Hold on to them tightly. You know, the world out there has so much that can threaten them. And so now we are moving on to two of the most outstanding of the most outstanding awards, the Principal's Award and the Award for Student of the Year. And so at this time, I would like to call on His Excellency, the Governor General, and our dear school principal, Miss Danielle, who will be giving out these awards.
Every year, my committee charges me with this responsibility to tell them who gets this most coveted prize. And oftentimes it's difficult, and I prefer the spirit to guide me, because I think all of you here deserve this award. But shortly before this is presented, we will allow our Governor General to present to the best cardinal sitting before us, the spirit of Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, Contribution to School Life Award, announced by Ms. Frederick and presented by our Governor General. And this prize goes to none other than the individual who has really, really contributed within and outside of the worlds of CCSS, bringing the life of CCSS to all platforms. Ms. Frederick? Okay. She was our junior Calypsonian. Woo! She continued to do the math.
Baby K.
And you see, everybody knows Kishana Smith from Form 1 to Form 2. And just recently, she anchored the OECS TV news, which is why Mr. Bissett said, this is a voice which will reach all your homes very soon. Thank you, Kishana. The next awardee gets a humanitarian award. This individual was so committed to his sibling, as she had to be wheeled to and through, in and out. And he waited for her, whether it was at the bathroom, at the tap,
And I think that this is most deserving. So ladies and gentlemen, join with me as we give tribute and thanks to Jaden Joseph. So Jaden will receive his award at some time, of course, but we all need to see who Jaden is. So come up, Jaden, and take the bow. And Governor General, allow me just these two others, because we're wrapping up. This is the end. We have an individual who came to us as one of the first form ones. She taught hair, social studies. Then she moved on to be a guidance counselor, and then the district counselor. And now, and for a short stint, served as the acting counselor of counselors coordinator in the absence of Mrs. Eugene. She has now moved on to new wheels, not retirement. I think she's put on some mags that will spin her off to Dubai. And so we wish her well. And so we call on Mrs. Patricia Susanna Valse to receive a small token from CCSS, the cardinal that you are, as you move on to greater heights, greater things. Youthfulness continues. Usefulness never ends. Continue and start a new chapter, Ms. Valse. And before the announcement of the last two, bittersweet, St. Mary's will be acquiring an asset of CCSS, but we are very generous, so we allow him to go. And so, Mr. Bissett, receive a little token of our appreciation, of your devotion, your commitment, your engagement over the past few years. Thank you, sir. I was hoping Chief would be here. She has extended her congratulations. I'd have loved for her to present this to you, because she said, okay. All right. Thank you, Mr. Bissett. And I lay down and I said, Jaden deserves it, and so does Yannick, and so does Kishana. But looking back over the years from Form 1, this little girl, when boys were not ready to play basketball, she was. When the Leo Alpha Club, Ms. Sparks can tell, had failed us by participating, Mr. Chris Emmanuel, her parent, ensured that she continued to persevere and represent CCSS. Very punctual, very actively engaged in every activity at CCSS. And this young lady, sometimes a little too much, she asked questions about anything she could not understand, and she wouldn't give up and give in to the challenges and pressures, and never bothered with what people thought. Skinny little Jada is the principal's awardee. I watch her. She is so passionate about what she does. I watch when the students left and she stood behind. She picked up all the bottles they left behind. A young person to emulate children. And so we've come to the end. Governor General, His Excellency, Mr. Errol Charles, as the criteria shared with parents and students says, all-round engagement and involvement, our distinguished coordinator of awards, Ms. Frederick, will present the Governor General and he will announce, I don't know if that's protocol. Okay. He will present the individual who best exemplifies the details, the ideals, the concept, the philosophy of CCSS. Behavior, overall performance, significant participation in extracurricular activities, leadership skills, and of course, the positive, energetic attitude that we expect from each student. Class of 2022, please stand as we announce the Student of the Year, none other than Zania Sunday. Come on, let's stand for your colleague students. Come on, stand up. Thank you so much, Your Excellency. And I will ask Mr. Clark to help us present to you a small token of our appreciation. I do hope that it's not going to add any burden to your muscles. The biggest one. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Your Excellency. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
As we wind down our program for this morning, I call on our salutatorian, the outgoing president of the school's Students' Council, Ms. Omika Common.
Good afternoon, everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. Permit me to follow the protocol that has already been established. Once, a great man said, feeling thankfulness and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. Today, I take the opportunity to put all my gratitude into words on behalf of Class of 2022. Words can't express how thankful we are to each and every one of you. Our journey through the walls has been such a rich and memorable experience. As we close this chapter of our lives, we express gratitude to everyone who made this graduation ceremony memorial. Gratitude goes out to all our sponsors for providing us with the necessary support and being so committed to our school life. Without you, none of this would have been a reality. What an amazing graduation ceremony. Hats off to our keynote speaker, Deacon Anthony, who rattled our bones with inspiration to never let failures define you. Our master of ceremony, who ensured proper execution of our ceremony. We would like to recognize our presenters of the various awards, Most importantly, our district education officer and class of 85. Honor goes out to our class valedictorian, Kishana Smith, who captivated the time shared with each other. We wish to acknowledge also Mr. Celestine and all those who savored us with special renditions. Thank you to our live streaming for capturing this special moment. We see you. We would also like to thank our sound system. Our deepest appreciation goes to our auxiliary staff. Our deepest appreciation goes out to our auxiliary staff and our best canteen proprietors. Miss Betty, a chicken burger. Our office staff, your services rendered did not go unnoticed. An immense thank you to our remarkable captains, Miss Danielle and Miss Elcock, along with all our teachers and HODs for the knowledge and skills you imparted to us. We are truly grateful for your inspiration on this milestone. And thank you for organizing this spectacular moment we share with you today. We would like to thank our Creator for giving us health and life and the resilience through those years. A special thank you to our attendees for gracing us with your presence today. Special thanks to His Excellency, ministry officials, special guests, our past principal, and most importantly, our parents, for making unimaginable sacrifices to provide us with the necessary support needed to flourish. While many individuals helped us to get to this point today, we would have never made it without putting in the necessary efforts ourselves. I commend you, my fellow graduates, for being able to withstand the pressures of life while remaining positive no matter the weather. I urge you to continue striving as the intellectual and phenomenal warriors that you are. Remember to always be grateful as you continue to set the world on fire. Thank you, class of 2022. We earned it. Free cheers for success. Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip. One more. Hip hip. Hooray. At this point, I would like to call on Nicholas Preville.
Hello, good afternoon. Well, I'd like to give thanks to everybody that came here, you know, y'all. I'll give thanks to the teachers. They worked very hard throughout the years. Give thanks to Mr. Closel. He actually looking nice for once, you know. 2 days in a row, he looking sharp, you know. I'd like to give thanks to all the other teachers, Miss Frederick, our room teacher. She looked out for us throughout the years. Give thanks to Mr. St. Luce, you know. He helped us a lot, especially the technical students, you know. Give thanks to all the teachers and anybody else that I missed out on. My friends, they know themselves. You know, big up all y'all.
The simple things are your blessings. Simple things, them are your blessings, your blessings. Simple things are your blessings.
The token will be presented afterwards.
Choose the friends where you keep. You know, watch where you eat. When last you get a good sleep, the simple things are your blessings. Simple things are your blessing. Your
graduates of the class of 2022. That's it, eh? 5 years at CCSS. Mission accomplished. So we wish you Godspeed as you go out into the world. And in whatever good you do, continue to pursue what is excellent, what is noble, what is good, what is pure. Whatever life brings to you, seize each day. And inspired by our school motto, make the most of each moment. And of course, as school administration and teachers, we are proud of you. Continue to make us and your family members proud. So at this time, we are going to sing our school anthem and pray our school prayer, hopefully not for the last time. Let these words remain in your heart. And to lead us, I call on our principal, Miss Danielle.
I'd like our head of department, Ms. Nicholas, who is one of our most seasoned HODs, to help with just a few additional certificates. We just have a few standing here, outstanding certificates. Phoebe Dovey, and these are for students who actually represented us both locally, in-house, and outside of CCSS. So just bear with us, please. Phoebe Dovey, as a member of the choir, participated, sung, played at cruise ships, hotels, outside of shopping plazas with the choir. And so we give this to you. Omika Common, Francophonie Activities, Student Council. Desiree Isenbert, Francophonie Activities, Students Council. Kishana Smith, Competitions, Calypso, host of OECS TV, Francophonie Celebrations. Melina Gibton's National Netball Team, Under 16, National Representation. Keithan Shalmine, Cricket, Under 17, National Representation. Oh yeah, it's all yours, so we can't leave them behind. Tayshon Dubisson, CCSS Track Team, Divisions 2 and 3 and 1. Ashel Faisal. And we asked Miss Nicholas, our other HOD who is present, to come help Miss Nicholas. As Kishana said, two Nicholases. All right. Ashel Faisal, our school squire, students council from Form 1, actually. Then we have our student Akela Xavier, musical renditions, volleyball tournaments, inter-school sports, shot put. We have Anaj Leon, inter-secondary school sports, netball. Alyssa Herbert, choir, Christmas carols at City Center. Sarah Raoul, women in science, natural science competition, 2019-20. Yannick Octave, swimming, and also our IT to go person. Unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to show you our nice Looney Tunes movie, whatever we want to call it, but we'll share it, parents and students, so you can see the beautiful work Yannick did. Michelle Joseph, inter-secondary school sports. Xenia Sandy, under 14 girls football. And we have the Leo's Club, Sharon Ephraim, representing the Alpha Leo Club, giving us a little token for Jada Emmanuel, most outstanding in terms of her commitment to the Leo's Club. Rayona Stone, Women in Science Competition, Spotlight and School Squire. These are theirs, so they need to get them. I know it's a little tedious. We've been here for 3 hours. But this is why we came. CCSS can't compare. No other school has the curriculum that we offer. None. So when people say pre-graduation long,
No other school compares. We are, and we continue to be. So let's sing proudly our school's anthem as we come to a close. And just before, students, let's just bow our heads and thank God for today as we say our school's prayer. Father, you created me in your image and likeness. I have come from you and I'm ordained to you. Watch over me. Inspire me to choose good and to avoid evil. And the strength to respond gently. Give me the courage to follow the truth, the grace to know you, love you, and serve you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And just before you leave, we will, as protocol dictates, we will allow the Governor General to be escorted out first. Parents, you'll be informed where our plan B is. We said tents, but we've not seen it because I suspect Carnival took all the tents away. But our plan B was the TCF lab. So you go through one door and you'll see the stations per homeroom and out to the other door. So we have refreshments, mini meals, sumptuous, delicious meals for every parent and student. So you'll go in, go out. The stage is yours. You can come up to take photos. And the rest of the day you can continue doing so, I'm sure. You will get the link with all the hundreds of photos and the email address for Mr. Mooney, who would like to say thank you to sir for your commitment. Quality photos, right, parents? You saw them in the envelopes. Let's give Mr. Mooney a round of applause. He makes every child look exactly what they are, superstars. All right, and thank you, everybody. Thank you, Mr. Bissett. And thank you, Malia from Creek's Funeral Home, for your contributions. After three. Two, three. Look to this day,
for it is like
the very life of life. In its brief course lie all the verities and realities of your existence, the bliss of growth, the glory of action, splendor of achievement. For yesterday is but a dream, and tomorrow is only a vision. But today, well lived, makes every yesterday a dream of happiness, and every tomorrow of hope. Look well, therefore, to this day. Such is the salutation of the dawn.
Beautiful. Thank you. You remain standing for the exit of His Excellency, the Governor General. And Mr. Bissett, please control the rest.
We thank His Excellency for spending this morning with us and all of our specially invited guests. Come along. We appreciate each of you. And now, graduates, you would make your final exit from this auditorium that you know so well. Wait a while, Vernon. Just a while, graduates.
be water, it could be rum, it could be any sea, everything going down.
It could be water, it could be rum, it could be any sea, everything going down. Cause the water's over me. And I bumps into the ground, it's over me. Now watch the girl and wine go down on the gong like it. Like it. Down on the gong like it. Like it. Down on the gong.
I don't mean to be so rude, darling, but we don't really watch face. Now you have your breakfast and drinking. We don't know how everything tastes. Well, you done spy by the bar. We have it here by the case. So if your feelings are a problem, well, tonight you will know your place. Waiting,
tell them good moon. Sakwa say, send for the punch and bring on the back of it. It's plenty bottles lined up like on a range. We go do it just like the other day. We don't care what people say.
It could be water, it could be rum, it could be any sea, everything going down.
It could be water, it could be rum, it could be any sea, everything going down. Cause the bottles over me, yeah.
The bottles over me,
yeah. And I walks into the crowd.
The bottles over me, yeah.
The bottles over me,
yeah.
Now watch the girl and wine go down and the gong like it.
Amazing, by amazing.